students, welcome back to our class. Today is e-business. Today is very, very important topic and very easy to understand, as you people are aware of the cellular networking. In this topic, we are going to learn about network or the data generation. That is 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G and upcoming 5G briefly. So, if people are aware of networking, in the last class we have discussed, in the third unit also. Once again, I'll just go for the small explanation or the meaning or introduction. What do you mean by cellular networking? See, a cellular networking is also a mobile networking, and it's a radio network distributed over land areas called cells. Each cell served by at least one fixed locations transceivers known as a cell site or base station. If you see here in this picture, you can able to understand that the cellular network is in the form of a cell. It is each is connected to each other depending on the area, from one area to another area. This is the boundary that the network will go within this particular area or a distance. Here in this picture it has been mentioned, and you can get the information clearly that rural area, that means in villages or out of the cities and districts, towns, you can see the network, how it will be easy. The population will be very less comparing to the dense or urban area. Now again, the network in the urban area, that is in the small cities and towns, the population of the peoples in the towns are some more higher comparing with the village area or remote area. And if you see here in the total metropolitan cities, the density of the urban peoples are here, and how the cells are connected to each other and how the network is passed. That's the reason we used to say it as cellular network is nothing but a mobile network, is a radio network distributed over land areas called cells. Depending on the land area, it is divided into a form of cell. Each cell is served by at least one fixed location. One fixed location will be there for this transceiver, and from where the network, from the satellite, we are going to get to the network transmitter. Now, if you see here in another picture, this is the one transmitter. It is going to give that network. It is coming over here and it is giving to one mobile, from one mobile to another mobile. That means wireless communication is taking place from one mobile to another mobile, from one network to another. Now, mobile network is also known as cellular network. See, this is the one more question. In the examination, he can ask you, what do you mean by cellular network? So don't get confused. Both the terms are similar. Mobile networking is also known as cellular networking, because the reasons are just I mentioned about that. The network is divided upon the area in the form of a cell. Now, they are made up of cells, which are areas of land that are typically hexagonal, which is in the form of hexagonal, where you can see the corners 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hexagon 6, and it is in the form of a gonal, hexagon. If I take the best example, is like honey bee, where we are having the husk of the honey bee. So it is in the which form, it is in the hexagonal form only, and that people can enjoy it. And like that, the network cellulars are also connected to each other. And what will happen in this hexagonal, we are having one, at least one transceiver cell tower will be there within that area or within that radio frequency will be there. These cells connect to one another and to telephone switches or exchanges or cable or network. Now, if you see here in this picture, how the frequency is taking place. These are divided into a cell, hexagonal cells, and with the help of, this is one area, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is in a different form. That means that 2 is connecting to 2. That means the network which is here, that means, for example, 1 is, it belongs to the Idea, 2 is belongs to the Reliance, 3 belongs to the Vodafone, whatever it may be we are having. So it is connecting to each other area. So that is the reason we are known, it is known as cellular networking, connecting to each other in the form of the cells. Now, the cellular networks are based on mobile phones or devices using cellular signals to connect to the internet. Wi-Fi uses radio frequency waves to provide high-speed internet access to connect devices. Cellular networks are based on mobile phones. What we are saying? Cellular networks are based on mobile phones and use networks spread over a wide area, and that network will be spread in a very wide area, and the people by sitting at one place, they can communicate to another person who is in another area without wire. So in the olden days, if I want to talk from my telephone, the wire will be there and it is going to have a connection with the network, and that person also having the wire to connect. But whereas here in this generation, the wireless networking has been gone totally, and wireless wire communication has been gone, and wireless communication is taking place. If you see here in this picture, this is a very big internet, and this is the content where we are having the providers, receivers, resource will be there. And this receiver give the information to the network transceivers. These are the transceivers of different area. And this virtual network slices will be there where it will be sharing the MNO and MVNO. And this is a physical network, how it is taking place. And this is a beta slice. And this is nothing but it is called as to reduce the cost, increase revenue and innovation. So the government is generating the income, that the communication networks are going to be pay the taxes to the government, and it is also getting generated from the public. The amount, if I want to connect or purchase a network or data or internet, I have to pay some amount. Now, cellular networks are based on mobile phones, as I was saying, and devices using cellular signals to connect the internet. Wi-Fi uses radio frequency waves. In the last class we have discussed. Once again, I will show you in the upcoming slide how the radio frequency waves will work and provide high-speed internet access to connected devices. Cellular networks are based on mobile phones and networks spread over a wide area. Yeah. Now, if you see here, this is the exact picture of a cellular network, how it is in the form of triangle and it is connected. We are having these zones, so it is going to connect. These are the access devices, actually nodes, you can say it's an anodes where it is connecting. Now, how many types of cellular networks are there? We are having so many, but few are there according to our syllabus. We have to go for it. One is the global system for mobile, that is GSM. Second one is core division multiple access, that is CDMA, and global system mobile is 1G. Whereas coming to the CDMA, it's coming in the second generation 2G, and universal mobile telecommunication system UMTS comes, it's related with the 3G technology, and long term evolution has been totally taken place for 4G, and adaptive communication it is going to become for 5G. So I hope students, the concept is clear, and now we'll learn one by one according to our timely. Now, first we'll go with the global system for mobile, that is GSM. GSM is a standard. It has been developed by the European countries, the Telecommunication Standards Institutions. European Telecommunication Standards Institution is an organization to describe the protocols for second generation. For upcoming second generation, what are the things are needed, it has given focus. And these digital cellular networks used by mobile devices such as mobile phones and tablets. Now, if you see here how the GSM is working. See, from the help of the satellite, we are getting the internet connection to the SMS center via transceiver. And this transceiver is giving the SMS via GSM modem. GSM modem, I'm using the word modem. Modem is a device where you can see on the picture. And this will help in taking the machine with connected with GSM phone or modem. And another side, when it is given that the recipient is there who is receiving the data or internet. With the help of this, again it is, this data is passing to the pager. On those days, the pagers was there, tablet and SMS gateway was there, satellite phones or smartphone, GSM, and laptop, everything was there, to the PC, personal computers. And now coming to the GSM, is a second generation digital mobile telephone standard using variation of time dimension multiple access, that is TDMA. It is the most usually widely used of the third digital wireless. That means TDMA has helped in working and showing the way for the 3G, whereas the GSM is helped to show the way for the 2G. And now this CDMA, that means code division manual access, is taking place over here. Now if you see here in the picture how this GSM is working, see, this is the WAN, wide area network, and how the GSM is working. We are having basic station 1, basic station 2, basic station 3, mobile phone and soft phone. Same here, we are having one antenna, the anode is there, and this antenna, antenna is providing the network to the basic stations. From these basic stations, again they are getting the IP network will be there. See, this is the LAN, local area network, and this is the WAN, wide area network. Again in the WAN, we are having IP, internet protocol network, which we have discussed in our third unit. Now this IP will, after receiving the IP address, and once the IP address is matched with that station, then it will start providing the internet to that basic stations. That basic station will provide the network to the antenna, and this antenna will receive the data, and it will provide the data in the internet to the mobile phones or systems. This is a chain. And how it working? See, this is the first SIP, IP, PBX box, and this is the gateway. From basic station it is coming to the gateway. Again from gateway we are having PAPX, and this how it is going to be managed by a server. Now another thing, GSM is a mobile communications modem. It stands for a global system for mobile communication, and GSM is an open and digital cellular technology used for transmitting mobile voice and data services operators at the 850 megahertz, 900 megahertz, 1800 megahertz and 1900 megahertz frequency bands. So what is this GSM is used on those days? This technology is used for receiving the voice or transferring the voice from one place to another place. See, I am using the word voice or data, not videos or pictures here. Only written data will be there where we are using to help for transferring it. So this GSM was help for opening the route for the 2G second generation, that is UCMA. Now we'll go for CDMA. If you see here in this picture how this generation mobile station is there, from router this is the network, or this is the transmitter. From transmitter we are getting direct connection to our mobile. When we are opening the mobile and when we want to call to a person who is in XYZ place, so we don't have any kind of how the person is connecting. The person is connecting only via GSM, global mobile communication. That means mobile communication system, global system for mobile communication. Now so by seeing this picture you can able to understand how this is connecting to each other via satellite, and how it is working with personal laptop or mobile phone or sometimes personal system or computer. Now we'll go for the second one, that is the 2G. here the code division multiple access is taking place, and code division multiple access is a channel, that is access and method used by various radio communications technologies. And CDMA is an example of multiple accesses where several transmitters can send information simultaneously over a single communication channel. That means in the olden days in GSM only we need one transmitter to be there from one to one, but whereas we can send multiple with the help of one transmitter, we can send to multiple transistors. We can access with that transistor to other transmitters and multiple times, and multiple information we can send address from a single channel. Now if you see here how this CDMA, that means code division multiple access, users send or receive data at the same time and at the same frequency, but in code. So how much time it is taking when I am sending the person a message? Now we are using 4G mobiles or the internet data, but whereas in the when it was in early 2000s or 2003 or 4, the people used to 4 or 5 I can say, so the people used to have the 2G and it is taking some seconds of time. But whereas the person is getting and receiving the data at the same time and at the same frequency, but in a code form. Similar to that case, many people talk to each other at the same time in a same room, but with different languages. A common set of codes are Walsh codes, which are orthogonal combination of 1 and 0 chips. It will be in a binary system form. And this chip's duration is much shorter than the symbol period. So when we are communicating our money, how much amount will be there, that much time period we are going to speak, and once the amount is over, the call will be disconnected. So this was taking place with the help of code division multiple access. We can talk with different people from one system or one device. Now, this code division multiple access is a sort of multiplexing that facilitates various signals to occupy a single transmission channel. It optimizes the use of available bandwidth. The technology is commonly used in ultra high frequency, that is nothing but UHF cellular telephone systems, and the bands ranging between 800 megahertz to 1.9 gigahertz. So it's very high end speed frequency will be there. Now see here, as I was saying that how the radio waves is working, this is mobile. When I am saying hi to a person, the green code is getting the purple code, and this is the green code. The purple code is person, he is also saying hi, and at the end he is getting bye or good. So this is a person, when he is communicating, he is also communicating here. When he is going this, it is taking. So these are the waves where the communication is taking place. When he is saying hi, how it is taking place, hi over here. In the same frequency from one transmitter, many communication is taking place. See, the first person is saying hi, who is in the purple color, and this message is going to his receiver, who is sitting here. And the same way, another person says go, and here it is in the green form, and the same, with the help of the same transmitter or from the same device, the message is going in the multiple way. One device and multiple talkers are taking place. So this is a technology which was developed by the CDMA, code division multiple access. We can go for multiple access. Now, code division multiple access system is very different from time and frequency multiplexing. In these systems, a user has access to the whole bandwidth for the entire duration. The basic principle is that different CDMA codes are used to distinguish among the different users. So we are having, if you see here in these pictures, you can able to understand. So this is my base station. From a base station, what is happening? This is the code one we're having. I am sending one code to one mobile one, code two to mobile two, like this. N number of codes are sending to N number of mobiles at the same time, same frequency and same code. How the code is working? With the help of first channel, second channel, third channel, and a number of channels are taking place. This is the link, how the CDMA is in which each channel is assigned a unique code. In every channel, that this color shows that a unique code is there, which is orthogonal to codes used by other users. A person is sitting in a one place and is saying hi, and the another person is saying the same time, same frequency, the code is going and it is not disturbing to that person. How it is happening? With the help of CDMA access, these codes are separated and it is reaching to a receiver, and the sender are communicating at the same time. For example, I am sitting in this room and I am calling to my XYZ faculty and I am saying hi sir. And another person is sitting in front of me, and the same time, and is also communicating to his XYZ person. When he's saying you go, he's saying he's giving the permission, you go. So what's happening? At the same time, no disturbance getting. My receiver is getting the information what I am sending, and the person who is opposite to me, who is sending the information to his receiver, is also getting the message, and no disturbance are taking place. Now, this one, some advantages and disadvantages, we'll have a look for CDMA. See, two disadvantages are there here. Expert has found it out. The higher complexity of a receiver, our receiver cannot just listen into the medium and start receiving it. There is a signal. So at a time, he can't listen. He needs some time unless and until the network will start the signal. If the signal is there, then only he is able to listen. If the signal is not there, he is unable to not listen. It means that all signals should have the same strength as a receiver, at a receiver. What the strength of the antenna, the signals are there from the sender, the same amount of signal should have to be there at the receiver side. Then only the communication will take place, or else it won't work in CDMA technology. Now, what are the advantages? All terminals can use the same frequency, no planning needed, huge space code will be there, and compared to frequency space. See, here an example has been given, 2 to the power of 32 multiple times code will be the space is that much. Interference is not coded. Forward error correction and encryptions can be easily integrated. Now we will go for the UMTS, Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. The universal mobile telecommunication is totally based on 3G, third generation. Now, the UMTS is a broadband or packed based 3G mobile cellular system based upon GSM standards. The specification of UMTS covers the entire network system, including the radio access network, the core network, and users authentication. In simple words, if I want to say you that, some days back, if I want to bring the internet to my laptop, I had to purchase a data driver that I have to connect. It will be like, that means data modem will be there. I have to connect to my mobile, like pen drive, the data like Tata or Reliance internet data will be there in that. We have to connect it and we have to recharge it, or we have to purchase it, what it may be. So all these technologies used to come in universal mobile telecommunication system. If you see here, there is a modem where it is having, see, user is using this, and here the node is coming. It's a very big channel. UMTS is working. See, for example, I want to show you here. A user is getting, and here the communication is taking place. Again, it's with the help of mobile, it's getting how it is working, how the domain is there, how the core of the factor network is taking place from one person to another person, from one place to another place, how it is working. So it is a very big protocol analyzer has been taking place in UMTS. Now, one more thing, in the private residential area, if you see this picture, you can able to understand, like this is a pico cell. Within these buildings, the network will be there. Now, zone 2, micro cell, that means from home to industry. In zone 3, macro cell, from server to home. Zone 4, worldwide or world cell and the satellite or within the country. This is from within the city, in the local area, within the local district, within the local state or country, and the whole. So the 2G satellites network was taking place, and with the help of 2G, it has been started that we need some more. So the public mobile and fixed networks will be there. And these are private residential and fixed networks will be here. Now, UMTS is a third generation broadband pack, transitions of text, digital voice, videos and multimedia, data rates up to 2 megabits per second. So in 3G, the people used to send not only voice digitized, but the text, video and multimedia data, like pictures you can send. And there is a speed, some rate of fixed speed was there, that is 2 Mbps. If it is having 2 Mbps space, then only it can go for it. Now, UMTS is based on the global system for mobile communication standard. This UMTS is also depend on GSM. Now see here, these pictures help you in identifying the, this is the cellular network tower. With the help of this, they are getting the internet or the network or signals to its UMTS internet PC card. With the help of the PC card, it is giving to its mobile router, and this mobile router, it is going to connect direct to your PC, or else it is taking with the help of Wi-Fi, other means Bluetooth. With the help of Bluetooth, it is getting to your laptop or storage or phone or desktop, whatever. Both are there, wire one, wireless. Now, this UMTS systems uses the same core network as the GPRS and uses entirely new radio reference interface. The mobile terminal in UMTS is called user equipment. The user equipment is connected to the node B over high speed up to 2 Mbps UU interface. The node B are the equipment of BTS in GSM and typically server itself side. If you see here node B, how it is taking place. If you see this picture, this is the mobile equipment. With this, I am going to connect with the server, the help of node B, and it is taking love and it is getting connected. And to whom I am calling, to whom it is getting, all these things are connected and shown. So with the help of these pictures, you can able to understand how the mobile phone is station is running and how the network is accessing and how the GPRS packet switch is taking place and how the core network is taking place. Now, we'll go for the next term, that is the long term evolution, and it is nothing but in short form, if I want to say 4G, now what we are using in this generation. So in 2010 itself, only the people have identified that 4G is going to become in future and 5G is also there. So no one had expected, but now you can see the examples are there in your hand itself only. In telecommunication, long-term evaluation is in standard for wireless broadband communication for mobile devices and data terminals based on the GSM, ADS and UMTS and HSPA technologies. It increases the capacity and speed using a different radio interface together with core network improvements. See here, by seeing this picture, you can able to understand how the internet has been gone. The smartphones are coming. Wireless, we no need how to connect the mobile or any kind of wire. And you can go anywhere else, you can send the touch screen. On those days, in the 3G, we use the buttons will be there. We have to type the message. But here, touching is there. Very smart. No need of keyboard. Hard part is not. All the things are coming the soft way. And they want to permanently, they want to close the problems of future. That's the reason it is known as long-term evolution. Now, the JIT, why we are saying, why the name has came here? So the GPP engineers name the technology long-term evolution because it represents the next step 4G in a progression from GSM, a 2G standard to UMTS, the 3G technology is based upon GSM, the upper layer of LTE based upon TCP and IP internet protocol, and support mixed data, voice, video and messaging traffic, everything is going to be taking place. Okay. Now, if you see here, these pictures will help you to identify how it is. In the starting days, we are having 1G and how the 2G, the small children are running. Then the 3G came, it is in the speed of an animal like leopard. Then the 4G came, it is in the, again we are having three generation, again three devices is there. One is in the form of a car, in the aeroplane, another in the rocket or missile. If you read this, you are able to understand what does it mean and how the standard is going to be there. Bandwidth will be there, spectrum resource will be there, model schemes will be there, peak data rate is there, everything it is there. So the data and the network is going in a very fast way without disturbing to the codes of other or any traffic message traffic is not taking place. Now, LTE advance is the next major steps in the evolution of our LTE network. It's a new network technology that expected to both help band-aid the massive increase in mobile data demand and deliver much higher data speeds for all. That means better coverage, greater stability and faster performance. Overall, the 4G gives us, it is covering the better coverage toward the network and signals. great stability. The stability is there for the long run, and the faster performance is there. The signals are connecting within a no time, or I can say that in a short span of seconds or time being. So the people are communicating everywhere. So in the olden days, if I want to communicate to a person who is in Middle East or in USA, it used to take some time. I had to call him and he should be present over there if he is there or not, sometimes network will be there or not. But whereas nowadays, I should have to be present over there because our wireless connection will be there. If the weather is not good, if the person placing is not sufficient, then he won't be able to contact them. But now by sitting at home, you can send the message or text the message. You can send the pictures, videos, voice or data information within a very fast performance. Now, what is LTE overall? I want to say here that in November 2004, the 3GPP began a project to define the long-term evolution of universal mobile telecommunication system cellular technology. What is the main purpose? To bring higher performance towards the data rates and reduce delay and latency and backwards compatible. That means wide application should be there and works with IP network, Internet Protocol Network. LTE is the next generation of mobile broadband technology. In 2004 only they have designed, but implementation started taking in 2015. Yes. If you see here, how this is the picture, by seeing the pictures you can able to understand that how this is going to tact and GSM, GPRS, ADS, what are in the 2G and in the 3G, WCDMA, HSP, HSP plus, and the 4G over here, missile or rocket is running, the network is running. Now see here, this is the last picture I want to show you, that with this you are able to understand that how the cellular networking takes place. First it was in the form of cellular and it was involved in the RAN form, UTRAN and ZRAN, the megabytes. Then it has been, this is given to a server core, and this we are having n number of servers. With the help of this server cores, we are having the trusted non-3GPP in IP address. So all this is taking place, okay. With the help of this, I hope students have understood what does it mean. Now, we'll go for the next one, is the last one, that is adaptive communication. And adaptive communication means switching between different communication styles based on contextual demands, drawing on a broad range of approaches to broaden and deepen your influence on others. That means to influence on others, this kind of communication is taking place, and this is nothing but adaptive communication. And in future, we are going to develop this kind of communication within a short span of time with the help of the cellular device. These features allow the cellular device to vary its power dynamically at any given time. This means that a cellular communication network using this technology and others may conduct dynamic communication adapted to the conditions of the ships and the quality of communication. So I hope students you have understand this, and with the help of this you are able to understand what in the cellular networking, what are the types and how it is working and how it is mandatory in today's life and how it is generating profits to public, government and everyone, and how we are going to communicate and sending the pictures, videos and the data, the information within a short span of time by sitting in our city to another country or the place where our friends, relatives and known persons are there. By this, we are going to complete our topic. Please mention your attendance in the comment box. Thank you.